In this video number 28, we're going to be talking about tonight, God is a God of order. Welcome everyone tonight to tonight's live broadcast. Thank you so much for joining us. I am your host, Vernitra Thomas, better known as Tweet, and this is our book club. Yes. So we are studying the book, Commanding Your Morning Today, written by Dr. Sidney Trim, and it's about unleashing the power of God in your life. Welcome everyone tonight. So it is day 28 of 40. We have 12 more days left. Welcome everyone tonight. I'm gonna see if I can get my light a little better here. Thank y'all for joining me tonight. Thank you for your patience. Yes, today is night 28. God is a God of order. We're going to be reading tonight. It's a short read, and we're going to jump back to the back of the book where we're going to put it into practice and activate the activation declarations. We're going to find out tonight what this book is all about, unleashing the power of God in your life. When I first came across this book, y'all, I didn't even know the power that I had on the inside of me. Like, I didn't know that I could change the course of my destiny. And I didn't know that I could speak something today and expect it to happen today. But I was at the right place at the right time, y'all, watching It's Supernatural, a broadcast much like much of you are watching now. Sid had a woman on his show who looked like me and who talked like me, okay? And I was intrigued. I had to know more about Sidney Trim, so I ordered her book, and her book came with a CD, and I listened to that CD, y'all, and I listened to that CD, and I listened to it until it became my own. And so we're going to let go of the activation declarations in the back of this book, really showing up to the book club every night at 8:30 Eastern Standard Time. It is really about taking our prayer life to the next level. You know, speaking those things that are not as though they were and watching them on purpose come to pass. So I'm excited tonight. My spirit is ignited because we're walking in favor with God and man. Ha, I love it. So we're going to find out tonight what, you know, it means that God is a God of order. And I pray that you all are blessed by the YouTube videos and the blogs that are coming along with each daily broadcast. Yesterday was so good. It was about applying wisdom. So if you did not read the blog or if you didn't watch the YouTube video, I encourage you, go back and watch it because it can help take your prayer life to the next level. But today, day 28, we're going to take a short read. We're going to put it into practice, and we're going to let go of the activation declarations. Welcome tonight, Meth Pro. Where are you dialing in from tonight? I'm here in Easley, South Carolina, trying to get my lighting right. Ain't nobody mad but the devil. God is good and worthy to be praised. Welcome tonight. Where are you dialing in from? I'm here in Easley, South Carolina. Yes, in the comfort of my own home, doing God's work. And what do y'all think about those positive statements behind me? You probably can't read them, but that's how I encourage my environment. I write on the walls. I write on papers. I color. So for most of you who are watching me or who follow me on social media, I posted a picture today of a drawing that I colored, I don't know, 3 or 4 years ago. But it brought me so much joy. So unleashing the power of God in your life, it's about opening up and allowing God's creative spirit to flow through you to take you to the next level, okay? So I'm excited tonight, day 28. We have 12 more days left. So now's a great time, y'all, to share this video if you have not already. You know why I ask you to share? I ask you to share because sharing is caring. Yes, and we care about each other here at Next Level Faith Call. So share this video, share this broadcast, will you? And for those who are watching the replay, thank you so much for catching the replay. I'm telling you, I know that, you know, it's not always convenient for everybody to show up at 8:30 or at the same time every day. But for you who slow life down or who squeeze 30 minutes in so that you can catch the replay, the 30 minutes that we have set aside here on Next Level Faith Call, thank you to all my replayers. Thank you to all my sharers, okay? And thank you for hashtagging my purpose-driven faith. Net Pro says live from Wally World. Charlotte, so you must be in Walmart. Welcome tonight. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's day 28, and we're having a great time in Jesus' name. So, tonight, make sure you stick around to the end of the broadcast, too. Because tonight, we're going to be pulling a name from our My Purpose Driven Faith, from our movement. And we're going to announce the winner tomorrow, though. So stick around towards the end of the broadcast. And we're going to draw someone's name, but we're going to announce it tomorrow on tomorrow's broadcast on Monday. So that'll be how many winners? Five winners? I want to say it'll be five winners for us starting on tomorrow, which is Monday. So thanks for hashtagging My Purpose Driven Faith. So y'all ready to get started tonight? Because I am. Welcome. So I'm going to take a sip of my water, and then we're going to get started with the reading tonight. So for those of you who want to take notes, now's a great time to get your notebook out, your pen and paper, because there'll be some awesome scriptures to help you with tonight, with bringing order into your life. So be encouraged tonight. But for those who don't want to write, for those of you who just want to sit back and listen to the smooth sounds of Renitra, I encourage you, now's a great time to open up your heart and just be ready to receive knowledge and information and wisdom like you've never heard it before. Thank y'all for joining me tonight, and welcome. That's good. All right, so for those of you who are following along in the book with me, we are in chapter 6, The Importance of Ordering Your Day. And we are today right after Applying Wisdom and right before Take Control of Your Day. So God is a God of order. It's right here where we are. And I pray y'all can see me good. My lighting doesn't seem to be as good as it normally is, but we're going to go on in Jesus' name. Welcome tonight. Okay, so here we go. So we experience that God is a God of order by consistency with the seasons, the tides, and the solar orbits. So we can order our lives because we know with accuracy the sun will set and rise again, how the seasons will change, the tides will turn, and the planets will rotate on their axles. Okay, there is a cadence and a rhythm to our lives because of the order God has put into place through the universe, which we are suspended, and nature within we dwell. Oh, that was a lot, but it was so good. We're talking about tonight, God is a God of order. So let me continue. From ecosystems to solar systems, God has set in motion patterns that we can study and document through what we call science. Okay, so God has provided the ultimate example of effective time management and order in the book of Genesis. Okay, in 6 days, he created the earth and everything in it. And on the seventh day, he rested. Okay, so it all went according to plan. Then there was an order to when and how he created what and when. And the suggestion and the progression of how he developed each organism and species. We're talking about tonight, God is a God of order. So God didn't waste his resources, especially his time. He was purposeful and concise as he unfolded life on our planet. So look at Noah, Joseph, Moses, and David. All were men of honor and order. So they were disciplined and dedicated, and they submitted themselves to God's commands. So they were bold and courageous because they understood the power of divine authority, okay? They followed and they knew how to follow orders, knowing the power available in submitting to God. Even Solomon understood the importance of order when he meticulously followed God's instructions and chain of commands to build the temple. Y'all remember? Okay? So we read in 2 Chronicles 8 and 16, "Now all the work of Solomon was well ordered from the day of the foundation of the house of the Lord until it was finished." Okay? So in the New Testament, we're urged by Paul regarding the God's church to be sure that in everything it is done properly and in order. How many times have we heard that? And again, that's coming from 1 Corinthians 14 and 40 for those of you who are taking notes. So order is actually a condition in which freedom from disorder or disruption is maintained through structures, systems, and protocols. I can say for me personally, and this is just getting off the grid, this has been part of my success as an entrepreneur for the last 6 years, because from my foundation, my mentors made sure that I understood having structures in place and having systems in place, and especially having protocols in place, a way in of order in which we do things. So again, on night 28, God is a God of order, okay? So when there's lack of order, rank or chain of command, whenever protocol is not present, or whenever a code of conduct is not preserved or understood, it brings emptiness, okay? It brings lack of purpose and meaning. So if your life is characterized by confusion and conflict and frustration or lack of direction, okay, it's an indication that you are deficient in the area of order. Okay, so where there is no order, there's no light. We're finding out tonight. I love it. Oh, that rhymes. So until you decide to reverse the perpetual cycle of disorder, you will continue the experiences of defeat and failure. Okay, so this principle is illustrated by the law of empathy, which is like a tendency to of the energy to dissipate it. Oh, she getting deep. And to go from one state of order to another state of disorder. Entropy, that's what the word is. E-N-T-R-O-P-Y. Entropy can be defined as a dispersal of energy. Unless you intentionally harness time and energy, unless you command it with your authority that you have been given, your life will dissolve into a state of chaos. And she's telling the truth here. And you will never experience the life of significance and fruitfulness God has purposed for you. So don't just let things happen in your life. Make things happen in your life. I love it. God is a God of order. And this encourages my spirit so much because, you know, if I didn't make this group happen, it would not have happened. You know, I'm so encouraged that if we don't have a set of protocols, we wouldn't have order in our group. Praise God Almighty. You know, if we didn't have a system set up where, you know, others could reach us outside of just seeing us on TV or outside of just hearing about us on social media, we would have disorder and chaos. But I thank God today that He has positioned all of us, okay? Because when I speak to you, I speak to myself. And I pray that when you speak to yourself, you speak to me, because we are one in Christ. Our God is a God in order, and He is bringing us into divine alignment. Hallelujah! In Jesus' name. I love it. So if you were taking notes very quickly, some of the scriptures that were highlighted tonight were 2 Chronicles 8 and 16. Okay, another powerful scripture that was highlighted tonight was 1 Corinthians 14 and 40. And another one came from Job 10 and 22. Okay? So what did y'all think about that read tonight, that God is a God of order? Powerful in Jesus' name. Welcome tonight. So let's put it into practice, y'all. I'm excited. So I have included a list of activation declarations that you can use during your time of prayer. So now this is not meant to become a binding religious practice or even a ritual, but it's set up to be a guideline and a framework to help launch you into practice of commanding your morning. So as you speak out these declarations, do so boldly but prayerfully, and ask the Holy Spirit to guide your words and your thoughts and your faith as you take command of your day. So every reader situation is unique and different, and only you know what your specific needs are. Okay? So this is a guide to help expand your understanding of what is possible. All things are possible to the one who believes. Let today be the day that you apprehend the power that God has allowed. Today, believing God, you have done it. You're doing it. God, you're doing great things. Father, we pray right now for your anointing. Hallelujah. And God, we thank you that we are receiving it. Even now as we speak, we're overflowing with blessings. Father, we pray for forgiveness. God, we thank you right now that we are forgiven by the blood of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. God, as we walk by faith and not by sight, God, we pray that the anointing, hallelujah, would break yokes. We pray that the anointing would lift burdens, God. Because your yoke is easy and your burden is light. Let hope come back into homes and marriages be healed. And Father, we pray for family and unity love. Father, we pray for the needs of the people. Even now as we speak, we're praying for miracles, hope, God, and a purpose-driven life. For it is in Jesus' name, God, we pray for your will to be done. Amen. Amen, amen, and amen. God is good all the time. Yes. So let's get our activation declarations. Hallelujah. Welcome tonight to the live broadcast. I'm going to take a sip of my water. Hallelujah. Anoint myself with oil. Welcome tonight, everyone. As I stand to command my morning, I decree it is a new day. Hallelujah. I now take authority over my day in the name of Jesus. Every element of my day shall cooperate with purpose and destiny. Today is the birthing of a new day. The season of frustration and failures, they're over. Today I walk into a season of success and prosperity. Old things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new. Today I press towards the mark of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Anything or anyone assigned to frustrate, hinder, or hurt me, I command to be moved out of my sphere of influence in Jesus' name. I command my day to fully cooperate with your original plan and purpose for it. Woo! I greet today with the great anticipation of all of the good things, God, you have in store for me. I decree and declare that a new day is dawning for my ministry. A new day is dawning for my finances. A new day is dawning for my relationships. A new day is dawning for my health. A new day is dawning for my community. I now download success, prosperity, health, wealth, vision, direction, ingenuity, creativity, spirituality, holiness, righteousness, peace, your abundance of resources from your spirit into my day. Yes, I now have a fresh excitement. I have a fresh renewed mind. I have a fresh zeal, zeal, more pep in my step. And I have a fresh anointing. And this anointing that is fresh on my life, it is lifting burdens. Hallelujah. It is destroying yokes. Because God, your yoke is easy and your burden is light. All powerful God, place your anointing upon me now. The anointing that is on my life for this season, for this mission, for this mandate, attracts only those with divinely ordained assignments. In Jesus' name, I reinforce, hallelujah, God, you are placing the anointing of warrior upon me, and every dominion and system that you have assigned for me now, hallelujah, I compensate from the enemy, and I release the law of dispossession, and every satanic or demonic squatter that is on my land, that is on my property, that is on my territory, I command you to go now in Jesus' name, for I am more than a conqueror. Strengthen the hedge of protection around my life, around my possessions, around my family, around my friends, around my ministry, hallelujah, around my associates, in Jesus' name. I am overtaken with blessings. I am blessed when I come, and I am blessed when I go. Almighty God, bless the works of my hands and allow awesome work opportunities to come into my life. Advances and raises and bonuses. Bless the works of my hands and allow wisdom and knowledge and understanding and assets and even investment strategies and benefits and promotions to come into my life, God. I'm praying for overtime and customers and clients and visions and bigger dreams and even multi-million dollar ideas, inventions, and strategies. Oh God, I'm praying for writing abilities and even bestsellers and classics, theological insights, innovative goods, and top of the world class services. I'm praying for sales and commissions, even favorable settlements, hallelujah, estates and inheritance, favorable settlements. God, I thank you that interest and dividends are coming in my name. God, I thank you for multiple streams of income with positive cash flow in my name. God, I thank you for profits and bonuses, even rebates and returns, checks in the mail with my name and my children's name on it, unexpected financial blessings for my business partners, hallelujah, and my friends and my associates. God, I thank you that we're praying even for wealth transfers, because you are our Jehovah Jireh. God, you supply every need according to your riches and glory in Christ Jesus. God, we're praying for real estate, intellectual property. God, we're praying for residential property. Hallelujah. Commercial property. Hallelujah. God, we're praying for secret riches and hidden treasures. Favor with our creditors. We're praying for increased income, bills paid, debts canceled, debt demolished, balances now zero. God, we're praying for supernatural increase and supply. Woo, God, we thank you even for synergetic relationships. People are pouring into us and we're pouring into others. God, we pray now for divine health. You are our Jehovah Jireh. God, you just keep blessing us over and over and over and over again. God, we pray now for quantum networks, quantum progress, even accelerated growth and development. You're teaching us new ways of living and new ways of working together. Hallelujah to the King of glory. Hallelujah to the blood of the Lamb. God, we're praying for strategic positioning. God, that you work everything together for our good, because we love you, Lord, and you're calling us by name according to your high purpose. God, we're praying today for unexpected gifts. Oh, yes, and wonderful surprises. We're praying for condominiums and contracts, favorable contracts today. Automobiles, hallelujah. Backup automobiles, spare automobiles. God, we're praying for the mechanics, the people who work in the automotive industry. God, we're praying now that you pour out a special blessing upon them. Bless their next generation, even as we speak, God, even for financial freedom living. Father, we're praying for self-sustaining cash flow, money management, management skills and time management skills and priority management skills. We're praying today for mind management skills and leadership skills. We're praying for effective communication skills, even negotiation skills. Hallelujah. Crisis management skills. We're praying today for change management skills. God, that you would be in the midst of change. We're praying for resource management skills. God, that you would organize and prioritize our resources to work together for our good. Even a kingdom millionaire mindset. Oh God, you own everything. Hallelujah. We are now kingdom millionaires. We not only make millions, but we give millions away too. Hallelujah. We give millions to other kingdom causes and community enrichment programs. We are the kingdom underwriters of kingdom initiatives and even enterprising activities and programs. Lord, according to your word, we declare, let integrity and uprightness preserve us, because we wait on you. Wherever we go, systems and institutions and cultures and environments and legislations and even codes and ordinances and regulations and policies, they all adjust to accommodate our divine purpose. We are fearfully and wonderfully made, and we are reminding principalities and powers and even familiar spirits that they have no right to touch our lives in any way, because we are in covenant with you, God, and you have us hidden in the secret place of the Most High. Everything about our lives are changing for the best. Hallelujah. We are healthy and we are physically fit. Our mind is fortified and resolute. Our emotions are sound and stable. In Jesus' name, the zeal of the Lord keeps filling our souls and spirit over and over and over again. Hallelujah to the King of Glory. Now let there be no demonic encroachment. Let there be no satanic squatters in the name of Jesus. I command you to get off of my property in the name of Jesus. I command you to get out of my sphere of influence in Jesus' name. I command you to get out of my family. Let there be no demonic encroachments. I command you to get out of my relationships, to get out of my finances, to get out of my body, and to get out of my mind. In Jesus' name, I am now commanding mountains to be removed and to be cast into the sea, because I'm gaining new territory now, new emotional territory. God, thank you. I bless you. New intellectual territory. God, I thank you and I bless you. I'm gaining new business territory. God, I thank you and I bless you for favor. Hallelujah. Mercy and grace in my business. God, I thank you that I'm making new room for new spiritual territory. You're taking us to the next level in Jesus' name. We're receiving new ministerial territories and even new financial territories. Yes. Father, we wait to see your finished product. Oh, we look forward to the day we'll be transformed into the image of your dear Son, Jesus Christ. Our deepest heart's desire is to be like Christ. Now we seal these declarations in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Now unto him who was able to keep us from falling, to present us faultless before his presence with exceeding joy. Hallelujah. To sustain our soul, our body, our mind, and our spirit. Hallelujah. To the Almighty God, to the King Eternal, be glory forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. Be glory. Hallelujah. We declare victory in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Powerful today. Woo, woo. God is good all the time. All right, so this is day 28 and we're wrapping up. So this is the conclusion. Thank y'all so much for hanging in here with us. So this is the conclusion of a new day. So this is the beginning of a new day. Now you have been given this day to use as you will. You can waste today or you can use today for good. But what you do with today, it is important, because you're actually exchanging a day of your life for today. When tomorrow comes, this day will be gone forever. and in its place is something you have left behind. Let it be something good. And the author is unknown. Wasn't that just powerful tonight? Woo! God showing up and showing out. Talking about God as a God of order tonight on day 28. 12 more days to go. I want to thank you all for joining us tonight. Now let's see who is our winner of the free custom bracelet. Let's see who our winner is for tonight. Can I get a drum roll, please? All right. Oh, wow. I got it right here. I know who it is, but you got to come back tomorrow to find out if you were the winner for this week. Oh, congratulations to all of our winners. Congratulations to Vicky was our first winner. Vicky was in Gardner, North Carolina. Congratulations, Vicky. Our second winner was Percy Glacier. Percy was in Mississippi, Jacksonville, Mississippi. Our third winner was Miss Rosa. Yes. And so our fourth winner will be announcing tomorrow. So come back tomorrow at 8:30 Eastern Standard Time. Hallelujah. And plus, we're going to be talking about take control of your day. So we got more wisdom and more knowledge to learn about taking our prayer life to the next level, unleashing the power of God in your life. If you have not already, purchase this book. It is such a great resource. This book has given me the confidence to sit in front of you all for 40 whole days, 6 weeks straight, whether I feel like it or not, holiday or no day, you know, weekend or weekday. This book has given me the courage, y'all, and the access and the power to believe, to know that all things are possible to the one who believes. And the activation declarations in the back of the book is what's really giving me the blueprint to create my day every day in Jesus' name. So if you would like to reach us, connect with us. If you email us, we'll email you back. Email us at nextlevelfaithcall@gmail.com. If you got a prayer request, we would love to touch and agree with you. God's will be done in your prayer request. But thank you so much for joining us tonight and hashtagging my purpose driven faith and joining us on other social media sites. Thank y'all so much. Come back tomorrow. Bring a friend with you. And God bless you. God is a God of order. Day 28. Oh, the 21-day challenge. I'm getting ready to go. Thank you also for taking the 21-day challenge with us. Shout out to Miss Tina because she's been uploading her videos every day. And I'm getting ready to upload mine. So have a good night, everyone, and be great. It's been an amazing week, Ian, and it's going to be an amazing week. God bless you. Good night. I am Vernitra Thomas, better known as Tweets, signing off. Peace, y'all.